How do you feel, you know, a few days out from the final? How's the team feeling?
Yeah, feeling really great. We're really relaxed. We had a really nice training session today in the absolute pouring rain. It was a bit of fun. It was like bringing out that inner child when you're under sixes and you're running around in the pouring rain and you just know that your parents are going to hate when you try and get in the car because you're just soaking wet. But it brought a little bit of that excitement back, and yeah, we're just so excited and privileged to be here at the same time. So it's a really fantastic sensation. Well, I think there's pressure on both teams. The Kiwis have three World Cups under their belt. We have one, you know, so the weight of history is with the Kiwis. They are very, very strong. They've been the pinnacle of the game for an extended period of time, and now it's a real it is actually really great between both sides, and we just want to get out there. We want to execute. We want to work our game plans properly, get to the points we want to get to, and achieve those little mini goals along the way. So do all of that, then we're hoping we'll remember the result,
but
I guarantee it will be a very physical event on Saturday.
Do you feel like his dominance is changing a little bit though? Like you mentioned, obviously, 2013, I think it was.
2013?
Yeah.
No, we won in 2013.
Sorry, so since 2013, you feel like that dominance is changing a little bit?
No, well, I think it's the arm wrestle analogy. It's swings back and forth, ebbs and flows between the two, and that's the nature of a really good contest between two really strong countries. And you know, like I said, Saturday we'll decide it for 2017. We'll decide who the next reigning world champion will be on Saturday, and it's going to be a fantastic chair.
Australia and New Zealand always have a strong rivalry, but the rivalry between these two teams is really strong. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
I think it's really strong because we've had the Nines against each other, and we have at the Anzac Day Test match as well, which is fantastic. So we've had four opportunities to play each other already this year, and then we've had the build-up with the World Cup where we didn't play each other, but you know, Australia, we went to Papua New Guinea, we played a game, and then we've had our World Cup games. We had a game in Hamilton, and then we had the World Cup games and finals as well. And just watching both teams really start to hone their skills and the physicality, and their executions coming off really nicely, and their combinations are working well in both teams. I think that's really, really exciting. So it's, like I said, it's going to be a cracking affair on Saturday. And I think that people who might not have ever watched Women's Rugby League before, if they turn on the television on Saturday and they watch our game, they will not be disappointed. I think they'll be Women's Rugby League fans.
Because it seems like the women's game has really gone leaps and bounds. There's a lot of momentum behind it.
Yes.
It's great to see. I mean, the standard of the contest that you see with New Zealand Australia is fantastic.
Absolutely, and product is the one thing that I think both teams are very cognizant that we need to get right. And it's not just about bashing and barging up the middle. It's about showing your physicality, using it, but then also playing off the back of that. And the things that roll off the back of the opportunities that a dominant pack has in the middle of the field is really important. And yeah, the skill sets. I think people will be absolutely amazed when they see it. And the athleticism that's on show. Both teams are strong, both teams are skillful. Again, Saturday's affair is going to be one for the ages.